All right, so mode, median, and mean. This is the 17th. And we're going to say we can use our stem on leaf diagram to calculate the mode, median, and mean. Now, I think it was Enrique said it yesterday. What actually is the mode, the median, and the mean? They are all what? Yeah, they're all averages. Good man, right, good. And we tend to think of the mean as being kind of the only average, but these are three different types of averages. So they are all types of average. So really, if somebody was to ask you to find the average of a piece of data, you could actually work out the mode, the median, or the mean. Okay, but just remember that they're all different types of average. And some of them are easier to work out than others. So just as a recap, so the mode is which one? Can you remember, Anne? What does it sound like? Mode, moo.
The first two letters. Kind
yeah,
of
the first two letters give it away. Enrique? It's the most common, right? It's the number which is most common, or the number that occurs most frequently. Mode. M-O for mode. M-O for most. That's a nice easy one to work out, because you're just looking to see which one occurs most often. What about the median? The middle number, is that you, Oscar? Mm-hmm. Good night. Which is in the middle. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. And I'm going to put of an ordered set of data. What do I mean by that? If it has to be ordered. Right, good. It has to be in ascending order. And the good thing is, when we do our stem and leaf diagram, is it in ascending order? Yeah, okay, so we're halfway there. Let's turn these phones off, please. Bryden? Mask, turn around. Whoever has got their phone on, turn it off. Check and make sure it's off, please. Okay, and the last one. Kai.
Add up everything.
Yep.
And then you divide by how much numbers.
And that is the mean. And we tend to think of the mean as being the most difficult one to work out. It's mean, it's nasty. We add up the numbers, and divide by however many there are. This makes me sad. Actually, no, it doesn't. It makes me angry. That's an angry face, apparently. And make more glasses. This is terrible. Okay. It's a mean thing for me to do to work out all of that stuff. Okay. The good thing is I'm not going to make you do another whole stem leaf diagram. We will look at the one that we have just done. So let's go back to our stem and leaf for this previous example on the trees. And what I'll do is I will just copy this and paste it into another. Copy. Paste. All right, so this is the one that we were just looking at, that you have just made. And let's see if we can work out the mean, the mode, and the median of these. We have got 11 minutes. Okay, so first off, the mode. Now, you can tell me what they think the mode is. This is where this gets interesting. The mode is the one that occurs the most often. Is there a problem? Now you said 7, Kai. Why did you say 7? There are 4 sevens. Now remember, we're looking for the number, and I should really put the key here as well so we can see what we're talking about. So let's put 17.3. It's 173. So this isn't just the number 3, okay? This 3 is 173. This 7 is 177. So I'm trying to find which number occurs the most often.
Yeah. 195 and 166. And 166
and 173. Right there, okay, so the problem with this is we've got a lot of numbers that occur an equal number at a time. So we've got, let's start up at the top here. So we've got 161. And we'll talk about this in just a second. We've also got, so that occurs how many times? Twice. We've also got 166. That occurs twice. We've also got 173. That occurs twice. We've got 177. That occurs twice. And we've got 195, that occurs twice. Now, technically we've got how many different modes? Yeah, we've got 5 different modes. So is this a good, perhaps a good way to find the average? Is this a good, it's probably not the best way at all. Yeah. What were you gonna say, Caden? Well, that would be like finding the median of the mode, which is maybe perhaps not a bad idea, but we wouldn't do that, okay? We would just see which one occurs the most often, and unfortunately these 5 occur the same number of times. Okay, now the good thing is in an exam it would be really obvious, okay? It would probably be a number and it would occur more times than any other number, okay? So it's easy enough to pick out. But in this case we would just say, okay, those are our modes. Not great, but we'll just leave it like that. Does that make sense how we got that? Those 5 numbers, Ryan, is that okay? All right, the median. So we said the median is the middle. So how are we going to figure out the middle number? I could put them all in the line. So up here, I think I've got them all in the line in here. And then what would you do then, Brighton? Yeah, you could work your way in. Into the middle, like that.
Yeah,
you could do that. Could I do that here as well?
Yes.
I could work my way in like this if I wanted. Okay, I could work my way in, and I don't mind if you do that. Let's think of another way we could do it. How many pieces of data do we have here?
18.
We've got 18 in total. And so the median is going to be around whereabouts. Going to be around the 9th, perhaps. So let's see if I work my way in. So there's 3 ways in, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so I'm left with these 2 numbers. So the median is going to have to be what? Because I've got an even number here. I've got, I just want to make this really obvious. 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 166, 173, sorry, 175. Okay, so if we put them in a big line and I work my way in, so I want to have the same number on each side. That's 4, 4. So I'm working my way in gradually. What do I notice whenever, do I get to a number in the middle? No, I get to these two. Okay, so what is the middle number going to be? Yeah, it's going to be in between these two, okay, 175 and 177, and I can see that in my table. When I work my way in, it's going to be in between 175 and 177. So it's going to be in between. Remember doing that from last year? No? So then what's the number in between them both? So 176. And then to find the mean, how do we do that? Add them all up and divide by?
18,
right. Do that for me now. You've got 4 minutes. Use your calculator. I'll do it too. What did we get when we added them all up?
177.277.
Is that with let's hear what you got when you added them all up first.
Oh.
Added them all up, Tyler?
Mm-hmm. I got it.
What did you get, Tyler?
I got 3,024.
Ooh. What did you get, Peter?
3,018.
3,018. What did you get, Enrique? Oh, come on. We're not leaving here until we get this done and get it done right. Caden, what did you get? Again? 3,191. Brighton?
3,004, but I
think
I pressed
times. Oscar? Okay, and Ryan, you're still doing it? Let's do it again. Come on, come on, come on, come on. We need to be really careful when we're putting them in.
I have one question.
Yeah.
About this. It goes 177.27,
and then it goes to a bunch of sevens, and then an eight.
So would you put 177.27 referring, or would you have to write all the numbers out to eight?
So you would put 177.
So it's like this.
And then it has an eight, yeah?
So if you wanted to do it, so it's 177.2, and then it's only the 7 that's recurring, yep.
So you just put a dot over the 7. Or you could put a little line just only over the 7.
Yeah. But since there's an 8, do you have to
write? Well, so what the calculator is doing is it's rounding it at the very end, okay? So it's saying instead of it going 777 and so on, let's just round that up to an 8. So essentially just ignore that, okay? Yeah. Okay, so did we add it up? What did we get? Yes, 3,191. We divide by, Ryan, we divide by 18, and we get
3,004.
Are you supposed to
say SD?
When you add them all up.
Yeah, like divide it by
18. Yeah, and then hit your SD button.
Yeah.
Guys, stop. Or this is going to take even longer. Okay, so when we add them all up, we get 3,191. If you didn't get that, okay, make sure to check it. Take your time with it. We're dividing by 18. And we get this number, 177.2. Now, is the 2 recurring? No, it's not. The 7 is the only part that's recurring, so I can put a dot or a line just over the 7. Okay, so these are 3 different types of average. We'll have another look at these again tomorrow. So now you can get packed up. Okay, remember, I tell you when to pack up, okay? Otherwise, it's just a bit rude.
I just know that I have to use it.
All right, look.